More than 4,400 kilometers away from the buzz and luxury of Moscow, daily life in the Buryat Republic is much more low-key. Many young people have moved out of the rural areas to the regional capital of Ulan-Ude or to other cities in Russia. The elderly work in their orchards or tend animals to supplement their pensions and make ends meet.
There is no work here. There is nothing. Everything is very expensive. That is why everyone has livestock, cows, horses, goats, whatever they can earn with their own work, with their own hands.
The economy of this republic, experts say, is a reflection of what's happening on a larger scale all over Russia as the country enters hard times.
We are in a crisis. There is no economic growth. Incomes are dropping and prices are rising. It is a difficult situation.
People's buying power has plummeted because of years of economic stagnation, analysts say.
We could say that Russia today is in a crisis, economic, social, and political. The system is not working as it should.
This situation is in contrast to the 1990s, when the situation was very bad, much worse than today's. But back then, there was hope.
Buryat's economy is internally driven, largely self-sustaining, and it exports very little.
Practically 80% of what we produce is sold within the republic. 15% goes to neighboring regions.
Aircraft manufacturing, both civil and military, is Buryat's main generator of revenue. But the industry is spread throughout Russia, part of a wealth distribution scheme left over from the Soviet Union.
Our country is enormous. We cannot have all of the factories in one place, also for security reasons. Evidently, logistics here are more difficult.
The policy, as experts see it, supports the notion that Moscow is maintaining a policy of economic centralization to ensure that far-flung regions remain dependent on the Kremlin.
The Republic's budget is 50 billion rubles, of which practically 50%, in other words 25 billion, are direct assistance from the federal budget, so the Republic is dependent on Moscow.
With a median salary of $600 per month and a stagnant economy, analysts say it should come as no surprise that many young people are choosing to look for a better future far away from here. For Ricardo Marquina in Ulan-Ude, Russia, Jim Randle, VOA News.